Hello students, myself Shiuli Chakrabarty, Assistant Professor, Department of IT, Asansol Engineering College. This is our computer organization class, class 16. In the last class, we covered about restoring division method. We'll be learning two binary division method. The first one is restoring division method. And in this class, we'll be covering non-restoring division method. In the restoring division method, we followed three steps. What was the three steps? The three steps were, the first was we did left shift of the AQ data. We have already explained the manual binary division method. We have explained the hardware circuit where to store which of the data. The A register, the Q register, the M register. Actually, the same circuit will be used over here also. The M register will be used to store the divisor data that we have learned in the last class also. The Q register will be used to store the dividend data. The A register will be initialized with zero. The number of zero that will be initializing that depends on the number of bit present in M. The SC count, that is sequence counter, will be initialized with the number of bit present in the Q register. This is the hardware architecture. The dividend will be stored in Q register. The divisor will be stored in M register. The accumulator register is used to perform the operation like restoring division method. In restoring division method, we learned three steps. The first step was the left shift operation of the AQ data. The second operation was A is equal to A minus M. Third operation was to check the sign of the A data, whether it is positive or negative. If it was positive, we accepted the subtraction. That means the partial division. That means that particular iteration where in this iteration, in which of the step we have done the subtraction, that process has been accepted by setting Q0B to be 1. But if the partial, after the subtraction, the partial result is negative, we cannot accept that. We could not accept it. We could not accept that subtraction. So what we did, we set Q0B to be 0 and we have restored to the earlier status. That means we get back to the earlier status. That was the step of the restoring division method. In this restoring, in this non-restoring division method, they are a little bit different. So we have written all these things that in the three main step of the restoring division operation that we followed, shift AQ register, just now I told. Then what we did? We did A is equal to A minus M. Then what we did? If A is positive, we set Q0 to be 1. Otherwise, we set Q0 to be 0 and restored it. That were the step of the restoring division method. In non-restoring division method, what we followed that the step 3 of the restoring division method, step 3 of the restoring method will be executed first. That means in non-restoring division method, first, we check the sign of the A. That means step 3 of the restoring division method. Step 2 is the step 1. That means then it will shift AQ register pair to the left. So then step 1 of restoring method means left shift of AQ. What is the remaining? Step 2. So in the third step, the step 2 of the restoring method, that is A is equal to A minus M. So the order of the steps of restoring method is being changed in non-restoring method with the aim of, with the aim that we will not be doing restoring in each of these steps. The main purpose is that we will not be restoring in each of these steps after doing the subtraction. And for that reason, we say this process as a non-restoring method. But at the last, to get the remainder, we have to do one restoration process. Basically, there is hidden restoration process. So we explain this matter in detail. what we are doing. So first we are doing that step three. That means first we are doing the sign of the A is getting checked. So first step is we are checking the sign of the A data. That means we are checking A n minus 1, whether it is 1 or it is 0. The first step is we are checking the data A n minus 1, whether it is positive or negative. If it is positive, we need to do something. Before doing all these things, first the action of the checking. So if it is positive, we do left shift. So what does it mean? If it is negative, we will not left shift. Yes, we do left shift. In each of the case, we will do left shift. So first we are considering the positive side. If A is positive, first we are doing left shift. So when we are doing left shift of A, what we are doing actually? If we are doing left shift of A, what we are doing actually? After left shift operation, suppose the data is 0, 1, 0. After left shift operation, what we get? We get 1, 0, 0. That means it gets multiplied by 2. So after left shift means the number get multiplied by 2. How many times we are doing shifting? Depending on that, the power of 2 appears. So here power of 2 is 1. So left shift of A means actually we found 2A. So we got 2A. Agreed or not? Yes. So after left shift operation, it becomes 2A. Then what we do? After left shift operation, next step is A is equal to A minus M. So we do 2A minus M. So we understood the positive side. If it is positive, then we do these steps. So if it is positive, we do left shift. After left shift operation, we do A is equal to A minus M. Because in that time, A is not ordinary A. A has already become twice of A because of the left shift operation. So the resultant we found 2A minus M. What if A is negative? If A is negative, the scenario is something different. So if my A data is negative, that means the data is negative. So what we do? Obviously, we have to do in case of restoring division method, we found that if it is negative, we need to do restoration and we need to get back to the earlier step. That means we have restored the data. But here what we are following, if it is negative, then we are doing left shift operation. We are doing left shift operation means what we are getting? We are getting twice of A. We are getting twice of A. So after this twice of A, what we will be doing? Do we have really twice of A? No, we don't have the twice of A. Rather, there is a hidden restoration. There is a hidden restoration, and due to that hidden restoration, A is not actually A. The A is actually A plus M. There is this story. I told you that hidden operations are there. So my A is actually not A. A is after restoration, what we can get back? We can get back A plus M. So now if we do left shift, I found twice of A plus M. That means what? That means I found 2A plus 2M. So we got 2A plus 2M. From this 2A plus 2M, then the third step, minus M. A is equal to A minus M. That means that minus M. So what will be the result? The result will be 2A plus 2M minus M. Means 2A plus M. So after subtraction, we got 2A plus M. May I represent it that left shifting A, that means twice A, then A is equal to A minus M. May I represent it left shifting A, that means twice of A, then A is equal to A plus M. But actually this is not the operation. The operation is that when it is negative, we are doing left shift and doing subtraction. Sorry, when it is positive, we are doing left shift and doing subtraction. When it is negative, first we are doing hidden restoration. That means A becoming A plus M. Then we are doing left shift, means twice of A plus M. Then we are doing minus M, that means 2A plus M. At the end, we need to do one must restoration step. If the remainder is negative, we need to go back to the earlier state so that we can have our actual remainder. So the process better be explained with the flowchart. Here we found the flowchart. So first what we are doing, in the restoration process, the third step was to check the sign. In non-restoring division, the first step was we were checking the sign. So if the sign is less than zero, that means if the sign is less than zero, that means it is negative. So we are doing left shift operation. Left shift means it is becoming twice of A. Then we are doing A is equal to A plus M. But if it is not less than zero, means positive, then also we are doing left shift operation. And then we are doing A is equal to, the data is due to strike through. I should have the strike through. So rather underline, yes. So after that, what we are doing? A is equal to A minus M. So once again, I'll be explaining a little bit. So I told you that when it is negative, we are doing left shift. Left shift means A become twice of A. And after that, so after checking the sign, we are doing left shift. Left shift means, so first step is checking the sign. The second step is left shift operation. After left shift operation, we found twice of A. Then what we are doing, A is equal to A plus M. Oh, I'm coming later on this. So this step should be, I first come to the negative status. So first, the second step is left shift. So left shift means we come to twice of A. So up to that much, we don't have any problem. Then we are doing A is equal to A minus M. So that means actually we are doing twice of A minus M. Okay. So for that reason, what we did, we are doing left shift. So we got 2A and then A becomes 2A. Then A is equal to A minus M. No problem. But when it is less than 0, that's why that time I jumped over there. So when this is less than 0, that means the number is negative. I told you that there is a hidden restoration process. Hidden restoration process means A is not A actually. At that time, we did restoration means our A becomes A plus M. That step is hidden. Why hidden? I'm proving this. So after restoration, this A become A plus M. Then we do left shift. So after left shift, what we found? We found twice of A plus twice of M. So in our algorithm, is there any step that we will be doing plus A plus M? No. In our algorithm, the next step is A is equal to A minus M. The actual step is A is equal to A minus M. So twice of A plus twice of M minus M. So what we found now? The resultant becomes twice of A 2M minus M. Means what happened? Means we got plus M. So the result is twice of A plus M. So may I represent it that left shift of A, then A is equal to A plus M. Because left shift of A means twice of A, then A is equal to A plus M. In actual algorithm, there is no such plus. But to make it simple, what we did, the actual hidden operations are executed. And after making it simplified, it has been implemented in the algorithm. So first, we are doing left shift. Then left shift of A. Then we are doing A is equal to A plus M. Basically, the step is following A is equal to A minus M after doing this hidden restoration. But to skip this restoration scheme, we have evaluated the result, we have calculated the result, and thereby we have applied the algorithm to make the process simpler one. So now here in the, when we will solve the problem, we will do what? Whether it is less than zero or it is not less than zero, we do left shift. If the data is negative, we do A is equal to. So if A is not less than 0, then we will do A is equal to A minus M. And when A is less than 0, we do A is equal to A plus M. And thereby, after getting the result, once again, we check the sign of the A. If the sign of the A is less than 0, that means negative. That means after subtraction, then also after subtraction, we found the result to be negative. Can we accept the subtraction? No. So Q0 is set to 0. No, it's not negative, it's positive. So we can accept the subtraction. So Qn is said to be 1. But there we are not following any restoration process. We are simply decrementing the count. The size variable is here initialized with count. So count is equal to count minus 1. And then we are checking the count variable, whether the count variable is been reached to 0 or not. If it has been reached to 0, the next step followed. If it has not been reached to 0, once again the three steps will be followed. The first step is check the sign. Second step is left shift operation. Third step is A is equal to A minus N. These three steps we need to remember, then and only we can write the algorithm very easily. So when my count variable has reached to 0, at that time we'll check the result. Now suppose A is less than 0. That means one more step we have followed. So at that time we need to do once the restoration process so that we can get back the remainder. So here we are followed A is equal to A plus M, and then we found in our data that RQ is having the quotient and RA is having the remainder data. And finally we got the result. Now we will solve one example to check. The same data we have taken, that 7 is Q and the 3 is M. Accumulator is initialized with 0 and our variable to be initialized with 4. So let us change the color. Okay, now see, this is accumulator, this is Q register, this is size variable. Okay, let us see what is the first step. Our step is to check the sign. Here, not shift operation. First step is to check the sign. What is the sign? Sign is obviously our sign is positive here. So we do left shift operation. Shift left. So after shift left, we got 0, 0, 0. So that 0 appears here. That 1 appears here. That 1 appears here. Where here we have found a vacant bit. Then after shift left, we found a n minus 1 positive. So a is equal to a minus n. That was the step, no? So if we found it to be positive, that means a less than 0, no. That means if we found it to be positive, so we do shift left, then a is equal to a minus n. So we do shift left, then a is equal to a minus n. Minus n is 101. So we have added, we found the result. Then what we to set the quotient, once again, we will check the sign of a. We will check the sign of A. What is the sign of the A? Sign of the A is 1. That means the data is negative. Since the data is negative, what do? We set Q0 bit to be 0. So we set Q0 bit to be 0. That means we cannot accept this. But we have not done any restoration process. Rather, what we did? We decremented our size counter, then we verified size has reached to 0 or not. Once again, we start next iteration. Again, we are verifying. What we are verifying? A n minus 1 positive or negative? Yes, it is negative. So if it is negative, then also do shift left. So that 1 we lost, that 0 appears to be there. We will not verify the sign of that because initially we are verifying the sign of that. So it is negative. That means we will be doing what? We will be doing A is equal to A plus M. So M means 0, 1, 1. So we do A is equal to A plus M. After shift left, obviously there is a vacant position. After doing plus operation, we found the result to be as 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So my result, still the result is negative. Since the result is negative, Q0 bit is set to 0. It cannot be accepted. The SC counter is been decremented by 1. Then again, has it reached to 0? No. So what do we need to do? We need to repeat the iteration. So what is the A data? It is positive or negative? The data is negative. Negative means in the next round, we'll be doing A is equal to A plus M. So first, before doing that, we do left shift. Okay, so we checked it is negative, then we did left shift. So that one vanishes, that one appears to be here, that zero appears to be here, that one appears to be here, that one is here, that zero is here, that zero appears here. So here we got a vacant bit. What we need to do? We have checked earlier it is negative, so we'll do a is equal to a plus m. So we are doing a is equal to a plus m. 1 plus 1, 0, 1 carry, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 carry, 1 plus 1, 0. To store the carry, we don't have anything. So we got 0, 0, 0. Now check, a n minus 1 is positive or negative? Yes, the data is positive. Since the leftmost bit is 0, the data is positive. Since it is positive, the Q0 bit is set to 1. So now, SC data again decremented by counter 1. Then what we need to do? We need to check. It is not raised to 0, so one more iteration. So we need to check AN minus 1 positive or negative. AN minus 1 is positive. So since it is positive, we need to do shift left operation. By shift left operation, that 0 vanishes, that 0 is here, that 1 appears to be here, that 1 appears to be here. Here we got a vacant bit. Then what we need to do is equal to a minus m. What is minus m? Minus m means 101. So 101 is here. Why we did? Because positive. So we can do is equal to a minus m. So minus m, after minus m, we found 110. That means the data is again negative. Since the data is negative, we set Q0 bit to be 0. Now decrementing this, we got 0. So do we continue the iteration? So here we found our count to be 0. So we come back here. After coming out from the loop, once again we need to check A. We are checking the A data. So A data is negative or positive? A data is negative. So here we need to do once the restoration process, because we need to get back the remainder. So 001 is here. So we are getting back this 001 after restoration process. And it was as it was, 0010. So our quotient is 2. Our remainder is 1. And this is the result. The same division, 7 divided by 3 with quotient 2 with the remainder 1. So in this way, you need to practice. One more example. The restoration assignment what I have given, you can practice that one also. One more assignment is given here, divide 9 by 5. So it depends on the practice, how many times we will practice, we can remember the algorithm, as well as it will become very easy to solve the algorithm. So for now, thank you.